Hi everyone and welcome to the big interview here on gsport. Today we are joined by a young lady who is dominating the international football scene. She is known as the Randfontein Ronaldinho, and when you've been given the nickname of a Brazilian legend, you surely know that she has got some incredible skills up her sleeve. Linda, thank you so much for joining us on gsport. How are things going for you in Sweden at the moment?
Thank you for having me, Celine. Besides being called this side, I've been enjoying my football. I've been learning a lot from my teammates and from my coaches. So I'm enjoying my journey so far. I can't complain.
We know that you are enjoying your journey because you started off the year on incredible notes. I mean, getting the Newcomer of the Year award in your first season. What, you know, does that mean to you, you know, just looking at your debut season for Djurgårdens?
I must say I didn't see that coming, getting a Newcomer of the Year, but again I would say it's because of my hard work and me getting out of my comfort zone, because I'm one who doesn't speak a lot, but last year I was able to ask questions, talk to players, asking for advices, and I think that played a huge role and hence I got the Newcomer of the Year.
You know, you just look at your growth, and as you said, you became more vocal, you know, being in the new, out of your comfort zone. But also 2022 was a really tough year for everyone. Sport was on hold, COVID-19 came in and literally smashed all plans out of the way. How was that for you, you know, looking at you, that could you join the team in January, by March the whole world is at a downfall. How was that for you, you know, just that tough period? Was it a much of a challenge for you?
It was really difficult for all of us this side, because I mean, it's the unforeseen circumstances, and I'm here to prove myself. I'm here to get some game time, and the corona thing comes, which slows down the process, which makes me question myself, am I gonna be able to play this side? You know, such questions. So it was very difficult. It was really difficult, but I'm glad that we were able to play a few games and I was able to prove my potential.
And looking at you going into the team, as I said, you know, COVID-19, the struggles, but what, like, when you look at the team and the style of play, and how was that for you, you know, just to get to know your teammates, I mean, and looking at what the coaches wanted from you, especially during that time when there wasn't any, you know, live action going on?
Like I said, I used to ask a lot of questions and I would look at a lot of videos. So I would take training videos, and in that way I get to understand my teammates, the movement that they do. And with the coaches, I'll ask them questions, what formation do we play? Why do we play this formation? And same as I think I've played a lot of positions last year. I've played as a right wing, left wing, second striker. So asking questions really helped me to adapt. Yeah.
Yeah, and awesome. You know, you look at your, okay, Djurgårdens being your third team being in, you know, overseas. How was that for you? Also looking at the experience that you've gotten in USA and in China, how did that help you, you know, just to be the player that you turned out at Djurgårdens?
Going to Houston, I wasn't alone. I was with Tembi and Janine. So, and I was very young, so I was very dependent to them. So they really helped me to be independent, I'd say. And I could really understand what it means being away from home. And also being to China with Tembi really helped me, so that when I get to Djurgårdens, I'll be able to be on my own. So I have the picture of how it feels like being away from home. So, yeah.
And speaking about being away from home, you mentioned, you know, going overseas at a very young age. How was it leaving your family behind in South Africa?
Well, I'll start first by, I was at HPC at the age of 12. So I was away from my parents at the age of 12. I would see them after 3 months, I think 4 months. So I'd say I was used to being away from them. So it wasn't that difficult to adjust for me. So, yeah.
And you looking at, you know, your just your career, like when was that first opportunity and how did it come that you got that chance to go and play overseas? When did that come about for you?
I think 2016 when I went to the Olympics. I think I had a very good tournament, and Coach Vera, who was a national coach, she got a team for me and Tembi in the Houston Dash, which she coached. So she's the one who gave me the opportunity to go play overseas, and that's how my journey in the overseas started.
And looking at, you know, just the growth of women's football, growth of your career, being on the international women's scene, we know that internationally, women's football is actually on a high compared to what we have in South Africa. How has it been for you just to be on the European scene and learning from European teams? How has that impacted your career?
Well, it has impacted a lot in my career because the level of professionalism this side and the fact that they take women's football seriously this side, they invest so much in them, where else back home it's still a struggle. Look at the level of professionalism that side, it's still lacking. We don't have sponsors, so we still have a lot of going to do. So it's a journey.
Definitely is a journey. And also, you know, we look at our South African players, the opportunities are coming, you know, or forthcoming. You really see how the international clubs are wanting our players to come play for them. What is it about South African players that grabs the attention of these international clubs?
It's very simple. I'd say qualifying for the World Cup really helped us. Qualifying for the World Cup for the very first time, and we were able to show our talents. I think that's one thing that played a huge role in our careers, World Cup.
The World Cup, definitely. Because when you look at the likes of Newcomer, Motlhalo, for example, her getting her first opportunity, you know, her first professional contract at overseas at her age, you know, being in her 30s, just looking at that, for example, how do you feel about when you heard that Noko had actually got this opportunity to play at such an older age and showing the example to the other children and other young girls that it is a possibility for them to go overseas, even at any age, literally?
Noko Matlo is a very patient player, and we all know how good she is, and it shows that you never give up on something that you really want, and that's what she did. And I truly speaking you that she's gonna get a chance one day. She's gonna get a chance, and she's the true definition of do not give up on your dreams. And that, yeah.
And that's something that I can actually say about you, that you know, not giving up on your dreams, especially with challenges coming along. And something that we really, football fans and everyone who watches you, follows you, is your personality. Your personality is really out there. We really love, you know, just the way that you are. You are very, you know, with your dance moves have really caught all of our attention. You keep us entertained all the time. What keeps you so motivated, you know, because you always have a smile on your face no matter what?
I come from a family that loves supporting one another, and we bond a lot of times, so they want to see me happy all the time, and that's what I took from my mom and my father. And I want to see my teammates happy. I want to bring that positive energy in the team, so I'm going to do my best to see my teammates smiling or everyone who's next to me to smile.
That is incredible. And also, just from your side, having the experience at 23 this year,
yeah,
having so much experience, what advice would you give to a young girl who's looking to, you know, just follow their dreams to be in a position that you are in today?
The advice I would give to young kids coming up, I would say don't give up on your dreams. Keep on asking questions. Refuse to be comfortable and find your why.
That's incredible. That, yeah, simple, straightforward. We love that. Also, now when you look at the future, what are you hoping, you know, hoping to achieve, especially with Banyana? We want to see, you know, more players coming through, but what are you hoping that you guys can achieve in the next few years, let's just say in the next 5 years or so?
It's to win the AFCON, because I'm always reminded of, oh, Linda, do you remember when we were in the final, you missed the penalty that if you had scored, we were going to get gold. So that's the aim, and to qualify for World Cup.
That is incredible. You know, you had to bring that up, but it's so true, because now you want to do better than what you did before. And that's so incredible. And, you know, Linda, just a message that you'd like to send to your fans. I mean, I know you got a great support out there. I see them on your social media always backing you up and always sending you so much love. What would you like to say to them?
The message I would love to say to my fans is I really appreciate their support, even though sometimes things don't go my way, they still supporting me, so I really do appreciate it, and I really do talk to them, so they must keep on messaging me. I'll keep on responding. I really do appreciate their support.
Awesome. And for G-Sport, I mean, looking at what we do for women's sports, how does it, you know, for you, do you think, what are your thoughts just on G-Sport and the work that we do to ensure that, you know, your stories are being told, especially in platforms like this with video interviews, something that we really don't see happening for women's sports?
Well, what the G-Sport is doing for women's football, they recognize talent and they give a young woman a voice, and they really do support, like I said, they really do support a hustle, I must say. This is a hustle. So we really do appreciate what the G-Sport is doing, and with the awards as well. Like, they recognize our hustle. So I'm really, really appreciating
that. And we appreciate you as well, you know, just for representing South Africa and making sure that, you know, the smiles on our faces and showing us as all women in sport that we can make it in any, you know, atmosphere, whether it's locally, whether it's internationally. So thank you so much for all that you are doing for South Africa.
Thank you.